Recently, we've been getting a lot of messages from you guys about this whole bundle selling situation. Also, when it comes to the component shortage, especially when it comes to graphics cards.
Today, we're going to explain to you guys what is up with this great GPU shortage. Technically,
COVID-19 has disrupted our lives in so many ways, and one of the things that helped people cope in these difficult times is actually gaming. However, in 2020, there was a massive graphics card shortage that has carried well over into 2021 and is not showing any signs of resolving itself.
People have been scrambling to get their hands on these new GPUs, but the prices have been skyrocketing. So what is happening?
In every situation like this, there's usually an issue in the relationship between supply and demand. And here are some basics in economics.
Basically, supply is the amount of products that are available in the market for consumers to purchase, while demand is the amount of products that consumers are willing to purchase at any given time.
The point at which supply meets demand is called the equilibrium, and it informs the market price, which actually considers things like handiwork, material, time, and effort into creating the product.
But when demand exceeds supply, things get a little crazy. Some people are willing to purchase the product for a way higher price, which then drives the price higher and higher until it gets out of hand.
And that is the point we are right now. So the supply is still very low, but the demand is ever increasing because of various reasons. Because people want to get their hands on GPUs, no matter the cost. I'm sure you guys are familiar with the whole pandemic situation that's raging around the globe. Okay, maybe not as much as the rage of gamers who can't get their hands on GPUs.
This affected GPU manufacturers for companies like Nvidia and AMD. They are unable to operate at full capacity due to new public health SOPs, such as social distancing, which then slows down their production rates tremendously.
Then there's the poor availability of raw materials required to make a functional GPU. A graphics card is actually more complex than you think. Other than the GPU chip itself that is made from silicone layered with tantalum and palladium transistors and capacitors for better storage on a smaller chip, there are also things such as the PCB and heatsink and whatnot, and they require materials such as aluminum, tin, zinc, copper, gold/silver, steel, ceramic, ABS/fiberglass, epoxy resin, etc. And the disruption in the acquisition or pricing of any of these raw materials can actually cause serious problems in the manufacturing process of a graphics card.
Moving down the supply chain, before a GPU reaches consumers' hands, there is also the issue of logistics. For decades, China has been the center of the world's manufacturing because of relatively low labor costs, making them the export hub of the world. But because they were the first to be hit by the pandemic, their lockdown has crippled carrier companies globally.
Now, the second half of this equation is the demand. Now, the current insane demand for graphics cards is actually coming from three different groups of people: gamers, miners, and people who work from home.
Stay-at-home orders around the world are keeping people safe but completely bored out of their minds. Of course, there is an increasing group of people who are building PCs to work from home. But let's face it, gamers now have all the time in the world to immerse themselves in new games like Cyberpunk 2077, which will definitely benefit from a brand spanking new GPU with features such as ray tracing.
Next, we have the villain of this narrative, which are miners. Okay, if you are a miner, here are your 15 seconds of fame. You're welcome. Okay, with the rise of cryptocurrencies such as Bitcoin, miners has become a driving force behind this GPU shortage. Who are miners? Okay, miners are basically people who use computers to compete in solving extremely complex mathematical questions and solutions to be then rewarded with something called cryptocurrency or Bitcoin. So there are things such as blockchain and stuff like that. But we're not gonna go too deep into that. So leave a comment down below if you want us to go deeper into that in the next Technically video.
Basically, because cryptocurrency values are increasing, sometimes exponentially, miners do not mind paying double or even triple just to obtain graphics cards, which really messes up the market price. Ultimately, this attracts vouchers, also known as scalpers, who are people buying up all the GPU stocks to resell them at crazy prices just to make a quick buck.
There are a lot of aspects when it comes to this whole US/China trade war, but when it comes to the graphics card shortage, here's what you need to know. In late 2020, the US placed restrictions on the biggest foundry in China, which is the SMIC, Semiconductor Manufacturing International, and this makes it difficult for them to acquire chip manufacturing gear and makes it difficult for them to sell finished products to countries with relations to the US of A. America! Truck, yeah!
So where does this leave the rest of us, the non-bangsawans, the normal people, and gamers who just want to upgrade their PCs to game at home? This leaves us with a sad fact that GPU prices will only continue skyrocketing, and our thin wallets will not be able to help us land that shiny new GPU. And even if you can afford it, the waiting time is significantly longer than before.
Representatives from both GPU and Nvidia have spoken up about this whole GPU shortage, and they think that it's going to carry on way into the end of Q1 2021. We are already nearing the end of Q1 2021, but I still see no one. GPU, get it? Nvidia has also started releasing stock of the GTX 1050 and RTX 2060 to help relieve this situation, and also they've started to make miner focused GPUs that has gotten Linus screaming louder than ever. It looks like prices aren't coming down anytime soon.
So Shane, what is your advice?
You can either save up your money and wait until the graphics card prices go back to normal, or pick one up secondhand if you can get a good deal.
So if you're already enjoying next level gaming at home, good for you. If not, hang in there, buddy, because it is going to take a while for suppliers to meet the demand.
And there's also things such as mobile and console gaming.
Which is almost gaming, but not.
What?